never thought that I would be making this video, but yeah, here it is. Welcome to Let's Meet Abroad. We are Adi and Mira. This year, we went on a road trip across Europe. After a few days of adventure in Switzerland, we headed to France for the world-famous trekking Tour du Mont Blanc. However, our trek didn't go as planned. Our bucket list hike took a complete U-turn. Join us on our adventure and figure out what happened.
We are here in Italy. Yesterday we arrived, and instead of being on the Tour de Mont Blanc, we are here, all first up. And that needs an explanation, because this was of course not our plan. I think like 2 months ago we decided to do the Tour de Mont Blanc, and I was so excited. Like, I love trekking. That's the thing I like the most on my holidays, to do a really cool multi-day hike or trek or however you call it. And so yeah, when we decided we're going to do this, I was thinking about it every day. I did so many research, I made plannings, and yeah, I told everyone like, we are going to do the Tour de Mont Blanc, and I just couldn't wait for it. So today is the day we are starting the Tour de Mont Blanc. We will go hiking for 10 days between 160 to 200 kilometers. And we will go camping, and we will face all kind of weathers, I think.
Yeah.
But we are super excited.
Yeah, and look at our two little buddies.
Yeah,
which would be on our backs the whole time.
Right now we are taking the cable car up to the main point from where we would start the trek. What's the main point called?
This goes from Les Houches to Bellevue. And you can also hike this, but people say just don't do it. It's a 2-hour boring hike through the forest, really steep. Just start there, because we have a really long day ahead.
Really long day.
On Thursday we prepared ourselves, and on Friday we left for the trek. And that morning we were super excited. We packed our bag, and we already felt it was a bit heavy.
So we just put our backpack for the first time this morning, and it already feels so much heavier than last night. Oh well, I think it's just a matter of getting used to it, and hopefully we survive.
And on top of that cable car, the starting point of the trek, we met an older couple from, I think they were from Canada, and they asked us, are you going to do the normal route from the Tour de Mont Blanc, or are you going to do the alternative one? And that's the high pass one, and that one should be really pretty. And when they asked us that, I was like, in my head I planned to do the normal one because the weather wasn't great, and they said you can just do the other one if the weather is super clear, and because of the stones it should be slippery. So I thought, okay, the weather is a bit scary for that, so let's just do the normal one. But when the older couple said they were doing the higher one, I was like, oh yay, I'm afraid to miss out now. So then we decided to do also the other one.
So 5 minutes in our trek, we're already lost.
Yeah, we have no clue. The signs aren't clear. Where I thought we were going is not on the signs yet, so I have no clue where we go.
So we're taking out the map again and figure out what to do.
It's going to be our best friend, this map.
Yeah.
So instead of doing the normal route, we choose to do the alternate high pass route on the first day. And there's a suspension bridge coming, something scary. And we have lots of these things. So, let's go for it.
We were just crossing this crazy uphill. I mean, we still have some uphill to go, and it's 12 degrees and we are super sweaty and warm. It's insane. And with our backpacks, almost like a crazy workout.
Okay.
Yeah, nice.
It's getting more and more foggy, like we cannot see even the mountains anymore. And we still have to go so long on this path, and they said never go this path if it's raining or something. So I'm a bit scared, like. And it was already 2 o'clock or 1 o'clock? 1 or 2 o'clock. And we had still 1 hour to go to Col de Tricot, the highest point. And from that point I thought, oh, I think it's from that point still like 6 hours. And
getting super misty.
We were around 3 at Col de Tricot, and of course we didn't see anything.
So we have reached to the highest point of this peak, and that was the lookout point.
It must be the prettiest spot of this whole day, like the spot not to miss. No.
Yeah, so probably going to the high pass, higher route was not the best idea, but at least we tried. And it's raining, it's getting a little bit cold. So yeah, not the prettiest first day, but yeah.
9 days to go.
Yeah.
For some food, we didn't eat anything yet, so.
Oh, yeah.
Like the rain was getting more and more serious. I didn't notice it that much because I had my rain jacket and I had my hat on. So yeah, you hear the rain. But then at the Col de Tricot, I took my back off, and then I saw, whoa, my back is really soaked, and I didn't put the rain cover yet. But then there, I think around 2:30 or so, we had our lunch, it was a cookie and an apple. And from Col de Tricot, we had to go down, 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 I think for 3 hours walking down.
Now it's all going downhill. It's crazy steep, and because it's raining, it's drizzling a little bit, all these things are a bit slippery. So we are climbing down, down, down. The mist has cleared up. He can now see more clearly. We left the clouds back up there, but the rain is pretty, I mean, it's not that bad, but it has gotten heavier. But yeah, we have still 3 to 4 hours to go. Things like this, when you're doing it, you ask yourself, why are you doing this? You can just sit at home and chill on your couch.
It was continuous raining, so it was a bit like all the rocks, and it was a bit muddy. And from that point, I'm really starting to feel serious, serious pain. Like normally going down, it's already tough, but now I was going down and this backpack, what apparently was 18 kilos, but every step it felt like boof, boof on your shoulders. So at one point I was like, I had so much pain that I couldn't concentrate that much anymore on the path. And a few times I felt over, like I fell to the back or so, or I was just like a bit like it gets black for your eyes, you know, that feeling.
All of a sudden, we see a little village there, and that could probably be our campsite, or maybe at least a place to stop. Because since last half an hour, or maybe one, oh, no, since last 2 hours, we are just walking in the clouds, and we could barely see anything in front of us. So yeah, now actually got some visibility. You can also see Mira. That's where we came from, all the way on the top.
And then finally, when we were all down, there was this little hut. Yeah, it's tough. It's really tough. Like, I knew it's going to be tough. Of course, you're carrying a heavy bag, but oh, the pain in your shoulders is just, it doesn't stop. And we have to continue still for like 1.5, no, let's make it 2 hours. But we have a little break. I have some more chocolate, but it's almost 4, so yeah. We will arrive in the evening.
Yeah. And I think our backpacks are way heavier than we anticipated. Mm-hmm. We really underestimated everything, and now you can feel it.
Oh, that's so nice.
Really?
Yeah.
Nice. That's what we needed. So that's gonna probably give us some energy for next 1.5 hours. And then we have to camp in this rain, so that's gonna be fun for day one. Your legs are shaking.
Yeah. we were both in pain, but like, yeah, it was not like, it's tough, okay, it's fine, and we continue, you know, that was more still the mindset there.
Fun starts. The whole track, it's a little bit slippery, but yeah, hopefully we don't slip, because that's gonna be fun. So we have some audience for us watching our super cool trekking journey. Look at that. Bonjour. Bonjour.
We ended up at the camping in Les Contamines, or a bit outside of the city. I think it was called Le Pontet camping. Really simple camping, and yeah, it was raining a lot, and we did have to eat dinner. So we asked them, like, can we sit here, like, where there was a cover? And they, no, this is the bar. Like, it was completely empty, you know, there was no one. Just let us sit there. But no, we had to sit somewhere in a corner in a really ugly dishwasher. Nah, yeah, it was a bit like, come on, jeez, what is the harm us eating our dinner there? But yeah, okay, we couldn't sit there, we had to sit half in the rain. That was fine, but we had to set up our tent, of course, also in the rain, so it was all of a bit of an adventure.
So we are having some
really nice. Oh, it just showed cheese. I grilled some cheese. I think it's kind of halloumi.
It tastes so good after such a long day, and yeah, all our body part is hurting now.
But really, that pain.
Yeah, so God knows what happens tomorrow, and we'll show you the tent.
The pain really came at that point. Like, of course, throughout the trek, the last 4 hours, the pain was also really bad. But when we arrived there, like, I saw Adi really struggling, like, he couldn't walk anymore, and I was like, whoa, you know, if he has a knee injury, and if that comes up, you know, like a knee injury, if that's there, you know, you cannot walk anymore. So I already started to think about, like, this might be a real serious issue, you know, and also, like, I also got serious pain, and my mindset is more like, oh, I'll just take a painkiller and just go for it. But yeah, Adi is a bit more smart, and he knows a bit more about body and everything, and he said, yeah, it's not really smart to take a painkiller to push the pain away if it's there becoming an injury. And yeah, that's true. So after our dinner and everything, we sat in our tent. I think finally we were in our tent at 8:30, and there we started to discuss, like, the serious of Adi, his pain, of the weight of our backpacks, and also my hip was also really hurting. And there we slowly came to the conclusion, like, it might be a really smart idea to stop this, to stop the trek. And that's really weird for us. Like, I cannot remember that I ever gave up on something. Like, that is not, you just go on, you know, you just continue whatever, you know, you have pain, fuck it, you go on. Yeah, it was getting serious. And Adi's also told, like, we will see tomorrow, you know, but I also already knew a bit, like, his back is not getting lighter. My back, yeah, I had some food in it, but we ate it, so it was lighter. But the next day you have to stock up food again. So my back is also not getting lighter. We are filming, of course. So lots of times we have to put our tripods and we walk and go back and everything. So we have to do like lots of stuff. And if you're in so much pain, then all this stuff is just getting so not fun anymore. And you're not enjoying it anymore. So we did make a really good decision to stop the trek and to go back to Les Houches, the starting point, the next day.
Everything is wet. And there's other campers.
It was really difficult, especially when you never gave up on something before. Like, I thought about this trek for two months every day, and I just, like, not giving up was never in my thoughts, you know, that wasn't an option, you just go on. But yeah, we did, and that's okay, just move on. And now we have a beautiful time in Italy, I believe, I hope, I'm sure.
Finally made it back to our car. That's where we were 24 hours before. So finally we found the weight measurement thing, and we'll see how much it weighs, because I have no clue.
Then it's so just 15.
Oh my god, that'll no. be really
And is the water full now?
No. I mean half,
oh,
yeah.
So half a liter extra. And yesterday you had food as well, right?
Yeah. No.
Oh no.
We'll see.
Oh no, I was taking that.
Yeah. 22. Come.
What?
So 22 kilos.
22. Shit. Yeah. And now mine.
But
and
I had 1.5 kilos of food yesterday.
And water, both
on 2 liters of water.
2 liters of water. What is it? 15?
16.
16, so 70, 18. 18. And they say like 15 is max, but that's like for diehards.
Of course. I still want to do this Tour de Mont Blanc. I hope already next year or the year after, and we learned from our mistake of the heavy bags, like, yeah, just take even less than less with you if you're on the track. And I do believe when we have a normal bag with just 10 kilos, maybe 12 kilos, it will be fine, I'm 100% sure. But a bag of 18 and I believe 18 or 22 kilos was just stupid, really. Like, what did we think that we could do that? This and hike is struggle, but when is the point that you think this is too much, you know, this is too much pain? And yeah, I don't know.